What's up, everyone? Today we're going to be installing a MrCool DIY ductless mini split. So it came in on the pallet the other day. This is an 18,000 BTU. It's a dual zone, so we're going to be doing it in two different rooms. And it came with our two inside air handlers, came with the outside condenser, and it came with our two separate quick connect line sets. So I got a 16 foot and a 25 foot. And I'm hoping it works out with not too much slack left over with these. So we're gonna get these over to the guest house where I'm gonna install it. We're gonna tear these boxes open, see what they came with, and start putting it in. All right, so the first thing I cracked open was the air handler to see what it came with. So we have the air handler here. Comes with your installation owner manual. We have a quick setup guide. Also, we have some things to control the AC, remote with battery, remote holder, USB to control it from your phone. We have a drain pipe, your anchors and bolt screws, filter. We have this right here, which will go around your refrigerant pipes. We have the wall mount guide. So this is what we'll put up to cut our holes and figure out where to put our screws. If we look on the back of the air handler here, you can see this is the setup. We have our electrical cable here. Also, we have, this is our, down here is our, looks like these are our refrigerant pipes here. In the back, you can see this is our drain tube. That always needs to go at the bottom when you install this, and it needs to be somewhat angled down so it can drain appropriately. So the goal is, with this, is to install it up here. This is the main room of the guest house. So we're gonna install it somewhere up here. And then we'll install the second one and the bedroom. If everything goes well, we'll be able to put it up here somewhere. The first thing we're gonna be doing is installing the air handler on the inside. And we've gone ahead and we've put up our template here. One thing you wanna keep in mind when putting this up is you want it about 6 inches from the top of this line to your ceiling. This gives you enough room to actually pop it onto your bracket when it's installed. The other thing too is you wanna bullet level so you can make sure that this is level. Your system's gonna work best if it is level. Next, what we're gonna do is we're gonna find the four areas where there are arrows. This is what's gonna hold the bracket in place, and we're just gonna take our screwdriver, push a hole through those, and make a mark on the wall. That way we can put this wall mount in place. Also, we're gonna wanna do the same right here when we cut this hole to push the cables through. That's gonna be a 3.5 inch hole, so you're gonna want a blade that'll cut through that. So we're gonna go ahead and do that ourselves. One thing also to keep in mind, if you can, you wanna put these on a stud because a stud's gonna work much better than using anchors. So we got our marks in place. We are gonna cut our hole now, and we have a 3.5 inch drill bit here to get through this. On the other side, we have a brick. So we're gonna use a different method to cut through that since this is not for brick. So we're gonna go ahead and get started cutting this one. All right, so I have this ceramic drill bit, and now that we have this hole cut out, what we're gonna do is we're gonna push it all the way through in the middle here, through the brick on the outside, so we know where we're gonna cut. We're gonna go on the outside to finish the cuts after this one. Okay, so we're on the other side of the wall. This is where the brick is that we have to cut out. You can see that hole I cut through. I went back with our original 3.5 inch blade and just traced around it with some markers so we know where to cut. And what we're gonna do is we're just gonna take this drill bit and we're just gonna punch maybe a dozen holes all around it
and then we'll take a chisel and knock the rest of this out. One thing to keep in mind, I'm not an overly cautious guy, but you definitely want to wear some safety glasses because this stuff will fly back and get in your eyes if you're not careful. So we have a handful of holes in here now. We're just going to follow up with a chisel and just break in between the holes a good bit. And we're just going to work it out slowly but surely. This is going to take a little bit of effort, but eventually we'll get this thing out. All right, so we went ahead and we have our indoor unit here. We bent these cables out straight. We already pushed our electrical cable through the tube since it's a lot longer, and we put our mounting bracket up. One thing, we ended up putting the screws in some different holes. That way we made sure that we were hitting the studs, so this thing is pretty secure. So now I'm gonna pick this thing up and clip it in place. You set it on the top and pop it down on the bottom. All right, after some working at it, we were able to get it in place. One thing is you may have to loosen up these bottom cables down here because they will press on the hole going outside. And then once it's in place, you might have to put a little force to pop it onto those bottom brackets. So now we are heading outside to attach these to the condenser. We're uncoiling this refrigerant line right here, this quick set line. You just want to be careful and slowly work it out like he's working it right now. You want to take your time on this and make sure that you don't kink the line, because if the line gets kinked, it's not gonna operate right and it could do a lot of damage to your system. All right, so we've put our condenser in. We've also run our lines along the top of the outside here. We're gonna wrap them to make it look a little bit better afterwards. I had to buy these brackets just to hold them in place, so you may wanna think about doing something like that. I know Mr. Cool has some kits to kind of clean up how everything looks outside as well. I went ahead and installed these off camera, and the best way to do it is you're gonna start with your A unit and install your larger line for A, then your smaller line for A. You're gonna hand tighten those two. Come back with your two wrenches, so you'll have a wrench on this left side and one on the right side. The one on the right side you'll tighten up, and the key is to get this flush right here. Once you feel it touch, don't really over tighten it too much at all, because if you do, you'll do some damage to it. Once all those lines are installed and snug, you're gonna come back with this tool here that came with it. And you're just gonna stick it in here, and you're gonna spin this all the way left as far as it'll go. You'll feel it stop, and that's good enough. You'll also hear the refrigerant releasing into the lines. You'll hear the pressure change, and that's a good thing. So the order you'll do that is you'll do top, bottom, and you should be good to go at that point with your lines. After attaching your refrigerant lines, you want to come back with some water mixed with soap, and you just want to squirt everywhere that you have connected them. So get it real wet, and if you look closely, if there is a leak of any sorts, you will see bubbling. And so we don't see it here. I didn't see it anywhere else on my other connections, so we are good to go. But make sure you do this because you do not want to leak. And for the electrical, since I have an 18,000 BTU unit, you're gonna wanna come and install a AC disconnect here with 10 gauge wire. That's what's recommended. So if it's recommended, I'd go with that. Obviously you have to buy this separately. You have to buy your electrical wire separately. And then we have this piece here, which goes from your AC disconnect to the AC itself. You can see I've already gone ahead and installed it, but I'm going to open it up and show you how it works. These are the lines that go to your inside units, and this is what the line that comes from your breaker box. So I'm going to open this up. Obviously there's four screws that you take this plate off, and then you can take this bottom plate off right here as well, which is what you will put your electrical wires into. Okay, now that I have it off, we can follow the lines. This is our main power. So you can see those come right here and come to this here. So these are your two hot wires. This is your neutral. Pretty straightforward, just slide them into place and screw them in. Of course, you have your ground here. Now, when you come over here to your inside unit lines, like I said earlier, you need to remember which unit you hooked up to the B and which one you hooked up to the A, because the electrical wire that goes with that should go to the right point on here. So you can see here my wire that I ran from unit number one, or unit A rather, is going to go onto this left side, and on the right side is our B interior unit. And once this is all in place, you are good to go to really hook everything back up and fire it up. Now that the power's restored, everything's hooked up, I went ahead and I put a battery in this remote, and you just hit the on button. The best way to make sure it's working is to skip the auto by hitting your mode, go over to cool, and kick your AC down a little bit. You'll see it's starting to blow. This piece will start moving a little bit, and eventually it'll get cold. Now, I just cut that on, and if you come out here, obviously this has not kicked in yet. It takes a minute, so be patient. Wait, you know, 4 or 5 minutes maybe, and eventually this will turn on. If you have dual zone like me, turn on both both rooms so that you can verify that they are cooling. And the other thing to keep in mind is this unit is really quiet, and I'll show you that in just a minute once it kicks on. All right, there we go. It has kicked on. As you can see, you can barely hear it. You can slightly hear it working over here, but it's not near as loud as a regular condenser for an air conditioning unit. So it's pretty nice, sounds great. Everything inside is cooling the way it should, and we are done with the installation. The last steps is we're going to come over here to these lines, and we have this piece right here. It's got a back. We will take this off, we'll wrap it around here where it connects on both of them, on both sides, and we will come back with our foam to fill in any open spots, and we can wrap the whole thing with this tape they gave us. I'm not gonna do that at this time because I'm gonna get some black tape or something that makes it a little darker and less obvious out here. But that is how I installed it. Overall, I hope this video was helpful. I hope you guys learned something from it. If you have any questions at all while you are installing one of these, you can shoot a message in the comments and I will try to respond as fast as possible. And if this video was helpful, do me a favor and hit the like button, subscribe, and thank you all so much for watching.